Okay, hi everyone. Today we will see five more current affairs according to our day 29 plan. So these are the topics to be discussed today. So the first topic is about agriculture voltage technology. Okay, this agriculture voltage technology is a component of Kusum project. We can say Pradhan Mantri Kisan Urja Suraksha Mahabhiyan scheme. Okay, so about 105 kilowatt capacity of agrivoltaic system, which is helpful for generation of electricity in the same piece of land where the commercial crops will also be cultivated. So this will save the income for the, or we can say it will save the or reduce the investment made by the farmers in the same piece of land. So it was developed by Indian Council of Agricultural Research, Central Arid Zone Research Institute, so which is in Jodhpur, Rajasthan. So what is the benefit of agriculture voltage technology? Is about increasing the income of the farmers, simultaneously producing the commercial crops as well as the generation of electricity in the same piece of land. Okay, so National Solar Energy Federation of India has documented 13 operational agrivoltaic systems in India. So these 13 operating agrivoltaic systems are managed by different photovoltaic functionaries and different public institutes are managing these 13 operational agrivoltaic systems. So please make note of Kusum scheme also. So in one of the current affairs session we have seen about the textiles, no? Okay, so geotextiles are there. We have seen about technical textiles and this one is about smart textiles. So smart textiles means the fibers or the materials or the structures which will sense and react to the environmental conditions or stimuli like temperature, humidity content. Okay, so there are three types of smart textiles: active smart textiles, passive smart textiles, ultra smart textiles are there. So we can see here passive is the first generation of smart textiles, which was we can say pioneer initiative. Okay, so they will just sense the external conditions. So next category is about active smart textiles, so they will respond to the external conditions. Okay, first passive will be just sensing the external conditions, but active will be responding to the external conditions, whereas we can say the ultra smart textiles will sense, react and adapt themselves to the external conditions. So it is we can say it is a pro of everything. Okay, they will have the properties like shape memories, okay, and storage and thermal regulated textiles will be there. So these are their properties. So just to make note of geotextiles also. Okay, also be clear in the differences between among the active, passive and the ultra smart textiles. Okay, that's all. So these smart textiles are very much important in defense sector too. So please make note of the applications of smart textiles. Okay, so next one is about Telecom Equipment and Services Export Promotion Council. So it is an independent body which is set up by a government of India. So the purpose of Telecom TEPC is about it will promote and develop the export of the telecom equipments and services, any kind of telecom equipments as well as services. So this will assist the Indian companies who are all coming under the ambit of TEPC. Okay, so it will help to cater the needs of the complete telecom ecosystem. So they will also organize and participate in the trade shows in some developing as well as the developed countries too. Okay, so make note of that, it is an independent body. So function of TEPC, so that itself enough. So next one is about Eka movement or unity movement. Almost we can say we are in 2021. So during the end of the 1921, this peasant movement has been started in Hardai, Barak and Sitapur in the United Provinces region. Okay, initially it was started by Congress and Khilafat movement. Later it was headed by the so-called low caste leader called Madari Pasi. Okay, so it involved some symbolic religious rituals too, because people will be owing to their land. Okay, and also what are the issues concerning Eka movement is very much important. High rents were there, Tikadas were, oppression of the Tikadas happened while collecting the revenues, and share rents was also there, practice of share rents is also in prevalence. So also read about the tribal movements and caste movements. If you see the Spectrum India book, there will be modern India Spectrum book, you can see they will be giving some tabulation just to have a quick revision. That's all. So Blue Natural Capital Financing Facility, so it will support the development of the Blue Natural Capital projects for ensuring the conservation of biodiversity, and because biodiversity we can say is the pillar of our planet Earth. Okay, it is managed by IUCN. So IUCN will act as the facility manager of a Blue Natural Capital Financing Facility. So on a day-to-day basis, the very much important word is day-to-day basis. They may ask you like biannually or annually and all. So day-to-day basis, they will act as the facility manager. So IUCN will execute the implementation of what are the projects happening under this Blue Natural Cap, under IUCN. Okay. So the main aim of Blue Natural Capital Financing Facility is about protecting, restoring and enhancing the natural ecosystems, because we have to adapt our environment according to the climate change, and also mitigation efforts should be taken. Okay. So we know that already Global Environment Facility will be there. Like that, this Blue Natural Capital Facility, financing facility, is managed by IUCN. Okay. So financing mechanism, that's all. So just to make note of who is managing and what is the function of a Blue Natural Capital Financing Facility as it is given here. That's all. So that's all for today's class. Thank you for watching. Till then, subscribe to Dream Work Achieve channel. Be bold, be strong, be happy, keep smiling and be grateful to each and every work you do. Please share this video to the needed aspirants also. That's all. Andre.